welcome to Wired Up Retro. Today we're doing a special episode on the game Missile Command and also trackballs. We're going to cover some information about trackballs. You know, they can be used on a variety of different kinds of games. Some of those games are not only Missile Command, but you can use it on Centipede. It's known to be very good on Millipede. This is an Atari 5200 version of Centipede. This is an Atari 2600 version of Millipede. They're both, in my book, really top-notch games for either game system. The 2600, you know, the graphics may not be quite as stellar, but the gameplay is very, very good. And you can play these games with this trackball. It's a very accurate digital controller for these 2600 games, such as Missile Command or Millipede, but you're not going to get analog control out of it like you would in the arcade. In other words, when you move the cursor in Missile Command, you're going to basically just get digital control. It's going to move the cursor. Let me show you something here. It'll move the cursor the same speed each time you move it. It doesn't go any faster than this, okay? Now, in a game made for, let's say, the 5200, which I will prepare for you, that one, Missile Command, is better, mainly because of the controls. I'll just get it set up here. The controls are analog, and you can't beat analog, you really can't. So here you can move that ball with precision, and it moves faster when you move it fast. It's definitely much, much more of an accurate gameplay experience to the arcade. There is a difference, though. This is the arcade had three Missile Command bases from which you launched missiles from, and the arcade unit had three buttons, one for the right base, one for the left base, and one for the one in the middle. This only has a middle base, so when you're playing the game, it's not quite like the arcade, but in the 80s, it was the best we had, and even to this day, this game actually plays very, very well, and I really enjoy it. All right, now I do want to touch a little bit on another console that had a version of Missile Command made for it. And by the way, this version of Missile Command, it might look on par with this version. It's definitely a step above the Atari 2600 version. This is the Genesis, it's called Arcade Classics, and this cartridge came with Missile Command as well as Centipede, and it actually is compatible with the Sega Sports Pad, which was made for the Sega Master System, and the Sega Master System controllers also work with Genesis games. Only one button's going to work. It's a single base Missile Command, just like all the others. Unfortunately, this doesn't act as an analog controller like this 5200 trackball does. It's more like this 2600 trackball. And from my feel, the feel of this is actually better when you're playing the game than this. Okay, it's close. I would say this is 85 to 90% as good as this. But, you know, when it comes to digital controls, it's just a little bit more jittery. You know, it's not bad, but it's just like above average. This is top notch when it comes to digital controls for those Atari 2600 games you want to play it with. This is above and beyond. This Atari 5200 trackball analog is just spot on. It's great. Now, another thing I wanted to talk about is on the Atari 2600, there was such a thing made by Rockland called the Unroller Controller. This is actually not a trackball. It's basically a joystick with clicking left, right, up, and down. It is kind of weird to play games with, but the other day I got Pac-Man or Ms. Pac-Man out, I can't remember which, and it actually is an accurate controller for digital control, but it's definitely not analog. This is the worst of the bunch when it comes to, you know, controllability. It's definitely an unroller controller. All right, so nextly, I did want to bring up a couple other things here. Let me put this aside. All right, so the Dreamcast actually made available, let me switch it over to Dreamcast here. All right, they made a game called the Atari Anniversary Edition Redo, okay? And this is a compilation disc with all sorts of classic games on it. And one of the games on it is Missile Command. And Missile Command has, amazingly, three bases. This is probably just straight-up emulation on the Dreamcast console. And there's a variety of different games. There is Centipede on this disc. There's also Tempest. And there's a few other games that could be also very good for analog controllers that fully are analog capable, such as Super Breakout. There's even Black Widow, if you want to try setting up two joysticks to control that. But anyway, I highly recommend this, and there's a reason behind that. And that has to do with a certain controller that was made for the Dreamcast. These things are becoming pretty scarce, but this is actually a Mad Catz controller called the Panther DC. And I believe they made a Panther XL for the PC. This is the Dreamcast version of that, basically. All right, so you've got all sorts of buttons, a trigger up front, you've got this, and you've got a start button, you've even got the left and right analog triggers. And what is this? Well, this is actually a an analog thumbstick mimicker, I guess you could say. And it is analog, and it works like a trackball on games like Missile Command, Tempest, etc. Okay? Now, these three buttons are kind of curious, you know, why would they put those there? You know, I guess if you're a lefty, you know, you might want to sometimes put your right hand on those buttons, but they're kind of out of the way, and it's kind of hard to get to them if you're using this ball. But one thing I think I figured out what they were trying to do was, on this game, Missile Command, you want three base control. You probably don't want to press that button and that button and that button for the three base control. But what you want to do is flip it around and use this as your left base, and that as your middle base, and that as your right base, and then use your right hand on the ball, and you can actually control your game like this, okay? This Panther DC controller is going to make this game just stellar. And I'll show you how to set it up. You have to first go to the controller settings, and I just use this little hat switch here. And you know, if you configure the left, right, up, and down, you're going to be doing it like this. You'll press the trigger to activate. When you want to go down, let's turn this around, you would slide this downwards. Oops, you got to hit this first. Slide that downwards. Try again. Didn't work. Okay. Now it says analog up to, and we're going to confirm that we want that. That's acceptable. Oops. Okay. Try again. There it goes, analog up two. And you do this for the alpha base, you would press this button to activate it. And the delta base is this middle one, and the omega base is this button. All right, so once you're done, you go exit the configuration settings and press one player start, and you're off to the races with three base Missile Command on a video game console. And sure, you could do this on a PC, and yeah, I don't have my PC set up to play games on a TV. I really like this Dreamcast because I've got a VGA connection, which makes the picture look extremely sharp on a TV, and I can't really get that with a PC. So you can see I was getting very good control. Now this is analog, and you can see I can make it go pretty fast across the screen, and I can make it go pretty slow, so it's fully analog. The thing that's a downside here is that it's a pushball. This is not like the 5200 with its trackball, which kind of has a little bit of spin action to it. This is, it's got a little spin action, but it's probably like 50% worse than what you got on the 5200. So yeah, I would say this is definitely a nice controller for playing Missile Command. It's definitely got good analog action, but unfortunately, it's just a push ball. It's not quite as fantastic as a trackball would be. Oh no, the world has ended. And there are other ways to end the world with this Atari trackball, and that would include playing Missile Command on the Atari 8-bit line of computers. This is my Atari 800 XL. I've got Millipede plugged in. That also works very nicely with the
Trackball by Atari. Another Atari computer that you can use trackball or even a mouse with is the Atari ST computer. That version of Missile Command for that system actually is a two-base Missile Command, which is definitely a unique iteration of the series. Nextly, we're going to talk a little bit about the Colecovision, and I'll be showing you some gameplay of not Missile Command, which was never made for the Colecovision, but some Missile Command clones for that game system, which are very unique, and I'll be looking forward to showing you a little bit about the roller controller and some of the games that were made for that besides Missile Command clones, games like Slither. And last but not least, I do want to touch on the fact that Sony PlayStation can play a Missile Command game, and just like the Dreamcast, you can enjoy some trackball action on that system. So we'll go into that here in just a couple minutes. All right, let's head on downstairs and I'll show you some good gameplay footage. All right, we're down in my living room. I've got Millipede plugged into my Atari 800XL, and my trackball by Atari is also plugged in there. We're going to give this a go and give it a shot. This was actually made for the Atari computer line, but it also got ported over to the Atari 5200 for people who really want to enjoy the game on that console, and it looks just like this. So that makes it kind of an extra special game. Got it. Shoot. Get that scarab. Ah. Oh, just missed the bonus. All right, so you can see this works. I'm going to switch over to my ColecoVision now. And what I have plugged into my ColecoVision is a game called War Room. This is actually a game that tries to go a step up above the game Missile Command, and I'll show you why here. This is the United States, and you're supposed to look up here and find the ICBMs and get rid of them. It's definitely a challenging game, and it's a little... yeah, you can tell this is one of those games. Oh, no. Got it. Alright. So, another game I want to show you, this kind of scrolls around the nation. I'm going to turn this off, and I'll throw in a different game that I definitely find similar. It's called War Games. War Room, War Games, you know. Give it a shot. This is the first time we've had the ColecoVision in action on Wired Up Retro. And this game console is a little finicky, but I could get it to work sometimes. All right, here we go. Get that plugged in and rolling here. Oh, there it goes. Try again. And I've got the roller controller, which is set into digital mode. This was made for specifically a game called Slither, and that comes in an analog mode. And so there, I think that might be the only game you can use in an analog mode on. I could be wrong. And they probably got some homebrew that utilize it in analog mode. But most of the time, you just put it in joystick mode, and you play your game with the roller controller that way. All right, so we're going to try taking a look at the country here, and you use your keypad to go to sector A, B, C, D, E, or F. So right now we've got a satellite going over. This satellite can be used to shoot down ICBMs, the missiles. All right, so we've got some missiles approaching here in this sector. I'm going to zoom up into that sector, and we'll send a jet to go get that ICBM, maybe. There we go. And we can get him down here to get that one too. He's intercepting. Come on. Get in. There we go.
And he'll get this one as well. He's gonna, ooh, come on, folks. There we go. Get that jet too. And we'll go back to the map. Take a look and see what's going on here. Yeah, totally, there we go. Select your jet and go up there and take care of business here. Get it. Oh, that was close. Oh, so you get the idea. It's kind of like Missile Command on a grander scale. So I do like that game. I want to also show you the game Slither, which was designed for the roller control. I'm going to click it over here into roller mode, and we'll plug that in. And I also have a little surprise for you here in a moment, but right now I'll just show you the Slither game. Get that to boot up on the first try. Hey, that some of them boot up always on the first try, and I like that. Okay, here we go. Slither. So this is actually, it was designed to compete with Atari's Centipede. All right. This is a game that has a little more flexibility in the shooter. And by the way, I am getting full analog control here. As you can see, I'm able to go fast or slow, and it's maybe not as nice of a roller controller or trackball as the Atari one. It's just not quite as responsive. But anyway, one nice thing about this game is you can go above and shoot them and shoot downwards. Let me go get that pterodactyl. Got him. Get him too. All right. So yeah, it's kind of a different mechanic for gameplay. It's definitely still quite a bit of fun. And okay, I'll show you my little surprise now. Turn that off. We'll head over to one more ColecoVision game that I have. And that is the game by Atari Soft called Centipede. Let's see if we can get it to work. Yeah, I've gotten this to work earlier this evening. There we go. Okay, Centipede, here we go. So again, I'm gonna put this over into joystick mode. Because, well, let's try it first on analog. Then it doesn't work. So I'm putting it back on joystick. The interesting thing is it actually is analog. I mean, it's, I believe you can go real slow and you can go real fast. So analog. But again, it's just not quite as nice as the Atari 5200. But the graphics, I mean, that spider looks a little bit nicer than 5200. So I think they just made it a year or two later for the ColecoVision, and that's probably why it looks a little bit better.
And one thing you can say is that Atari really does know how to program very well. This is a very smooth moving game. It's definitely very challenging. I would say definitely fun. I'm having a good time. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and move on to the PlayStation. As I had promised, we're going to show you a little bit of what the PlayStation offers when it comes to Missile Command and PlayStation 2 as well as the Xbox.
So a little earlier on in the video, I had mentioned that there's a Dreamcast version of Atari Anniversary Edition. There's also this Atari Anniversary Edition Redo. This is basically a PlayStation version. I think I held this one up when I was meaning to hold the Dreamcast version up. There's a difference. One's got the Redo name and the other doesn't. Really, they've just swapped out a couple games. On the Dreamcast version, you can actually play Crystal Castles where you cannot on the PlayStation version. And Crystal Castles is a really nice game to play with a trackball. And this is the classic trackball made by Nyko, which is a PlayStation 1 specific controller. It's only going to work on PlayStation 1 games, not PlayStation 2. It is basically a mouse mimicker for those PlayStation 1 games that were designed to be used with a mouse. Fortunately, one game that is designed to be used with a mouse, is this Atari Anniversary Edition redo. How does it work? Well, I will say that I like it. It definitely doesn't have a lot of heavy spin, so it's not going to be quite as nice as the Atari 5200 trackball or even the 2600 trackball when it comes to spin. It also has just an L and an R button, so if you're playing on this game, Missile Command, and you want to have, it has the three bases at the bottom. You press the L button for the left base and the R button for the right base, and if you want to launch missiles from the middle base, you have to press these buttons at the same time. So it's kind of a little bit of a hassle or a pain, but it does work. And this is great for use on Centipede or Millipede. Actually, that's another thing. In the PlayStation version, Millipede is absent. It is present in the Dreamcast edition. Now, one thing that PlayStation version has that the Dreamcast version doesn't is Black Widow. And I think I had mentioned Dreamcast having that. No, it's on the PlayStation version. And also it has a game called Space Duel, which wasn't available on Dreamcast. So anyway, we're going to delve into the PlayStation realm at this point. And instead of using the classic trackball, which, you know, it is a nice trackball, it's a little jittery in the gameplay of these classic games. I'm going to use a trackball that's actually superior to this, and it is going to require some use of adapters. So let's go into it a little bit. I have an adapter called the Smart Joy Frag, and this is actually the Xbox version. I own a couple of these. And I have looked for the PlayStation 1 or 2 version of the Smart Joy Frag. It's basically a mouse and keyboard adapter, allowing you to use those kind of controllers on your PlayStation or PlayStation 2. Those are very, very hard to find for the PlayStation consoles. Easy to find for the Xbox, as of right now, the original Xbox. So if you do grab one of these, you're going to need an additional adapter, which would allow an Xbox controller to work on a PlayStation or PlayStation 2. That is an adapter called the XP Joy Box. Unfortunately, that is very, very rare. But I happen to have a couple of those, and I've just plugged this into the XP Joy Box, plugged it all up into my PlayStation 2. I dropped my PlayStation 1 disc in of Atari Anniversary Edition Redo, and lo and behold, I've got a way to play my games with an alternate trackball. So let me show you that. Initially, I tried this Logitech trackball, and it does have a fair amount of spin to it. It's got a button here, here, and here. This is called the Trackman Vista. I would say it's kind of more of a pushball, not so much a trackball. Then, more recently, I've managed to come upon a different PC trackball. By the way, these are all the PS2 mouse connector, okay, not the USB. You have to use PS2 connectors with the Smart Joy Frag connector, so I'm just letting you know that. I find these at thrift stores. This one, hey look, $1.99. It was a pretty good deal that day. This is called the Belkin Trackmaster. And this, by far, is better than the Logitech, mainly because it has a real spin to it. And I've played using this controller on the game Tempest, and it actually, it's like almost having a spinner. It's so great. It really does get you some really good spin action. And the nice thing about this is you're not dealing just with the L and R buttons, and navigating the menus is actually easier using this because it has also connected to the Smart Joy Frag a keyboard, okay? You use the backspace, you can use the enter button, there's also a space bar for the main fire button on most games, like let's say Centipede for instance. Some of the other buttons utilized are Y, X, and I think B was in use as well. So you can actually assign buttons in the menus here if you wish to, using these two buttons right here. I don't think this one's assignable. If it is, I haven't figured it out yet. There are instructions that come with the Smart Joy Frag, which do help you delve a little bit further into programming specific buttons on this controller. So anyways, let's go ahead and take a look at Missile Command, since that's what our episode is primarily about today. Does take a little getting used to with that keyboard. All right, you get the idea. So we're going to go on to Tempest, and I will show you some cool things about Tempest. On Tempest, you want to go to Settings and Game Controller Options. And analog options, and you want to do reverse. I already set it to reversed, and the idea behind that is so that you can turn this around the other way, and actually in holding it, this will be your button for regular fire, and that's Super Zapper right there. So we're going to use that reversed so I can use my right hand on the ball. All right, so we're saving and exiting. And let's try it out. Like I said, this has that spinning capability like that. Works really well. I'm not exactly great at Tempest, but get the idea. You enjoyed our episode today. We had a lot of information. Basically, these PlayStation 1, even Dreamcast games could be played with trackballs. Maybe you didn't know about that before. Three-base Missile Command. Who would have thought? Also, PlayStation 2 games, such as in the Atari anthology, can be played. And I'm going to touch on some of these on our next episode. And by the way, this does include Missile Command from the arcade with the three-base. As well as Tempest as well. But instead of just using these little dinky PC trackballs, maybe next time I'm going to be delving into something a bit more huge. Let's just put it this way. The X-Arcade Tank Stick. Let's give it a shot. Man, this thing is heavy. But this definitely has some serious spinability. I mean, that's like the most spinning of any trackball you're going to find in a home setting. So I'm really looking forward to experimenting with this a little bit on both PlayStation 2 and original Xbox. And I'm also going to do a little experiment involving the Atari 7800. Actually, the experiment has been done and it's succeeded on Robotron 2084 using both of these joysticks to put the game into action. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'll also show you a couple other little special things about this controller. And, oh yeah, one more thing, Black Widow. Let's just put it that way. It's kind of a similar game to Robotron, and it's a whole lot of fun using the tank stick. All right, so I guess that's about it for today. I hope you guys have a wonderful new year, and we'll talk to you soon.